Welcome back to the basics of screencasting. In this video, I'm going to walk you through the interface of your screencasting software. I'll first cover OBS Studio and then a bit of Camtasia at the end. Once you have OBS downloaded, you'll see this when you open it. This box labeled sources is what you'll be capturing. For our purposes, we want to capture our screen. To do that, click on the plus button and go to Display Capture. You can name this anything you want. Once you click OK, you'll get options to switch monitors if that's part of your setup. Check the mouse capture button if you want the software to capture your mouse during your tutorial. These arrows here just change the priority of the screens that we are capturing. So make sure we move the one we just created onto the very top. If you don't want to capture your entire screen, you can also click on Window Capture and just select the specific window you want to be recorded. The next box we're going to look at is the mixer box. This box is where your audio is going to be. So that could include the desktop audio or your microphone audio. To change the source of this audio, click on the gear icon and then click on properties. Then you'll be able to switch to the microphone that you're using. Since OBS lets you record multiple sources at once, this is what this box scene and scene transition is for. A useful way to use this feature is when you want to switch between slides or specific softwares, between that and your main screen capture. To keep things simple, I'll just focus on the main screen recording for now. In that big box, or the main part of OBS, you can move and scale your screen recording to your liking, to ensure you have everything you need before you click that Start Recording button. Let's hit the Start Recording button and record something to test. I'm just gonna draw something here and pretend to talk about OBS a bit. Alright, to stop the screen recording, you just click that same button. To view your recording, click on File and Show Recording, and it'll take you to where your recording is saved at. If you'd like to change where your recording goes, click on Settings and then the Output button. There you'll be able to change the recording path. Remember where this file is because we'll be needing it in the following tutorial. For those that decide to use Camtasia Studio, let me just go over the interface for that really quickly. Note that the options for Camtasia will be similar to Snagit because they're owned by the same company. In the menu bar, you will have an option to record your screen. In the software itself, there will be a red recording button on the top left if that's where you want to start. After you click on it, this menu bar will appear. There you can record your screen, your webcam, your microphone, or your system audio. To change input sources, we can click on the little arrows on the right. Either click Choose Region or another monitor we have connected. The arrow below the source is just to show you what you're capturing. If you select both the webcam and screen capture, you will have options to manipulate both after you hit stop recording. Once we hit stop recording, our files will be inputted into Camtasia Editor for further processing. At this point, I'd suggest you make a project folder for all your files and save your video file there. Now that we've learned how to capture our screen and have a file of our screen recording, it's time to learn about Premiere Pro. I'll see you in the next chapter.